making an active choice to integrate with his family because it is a way to get more deeply connected to him and his family. And by choosing not to, that could actually, like, in her view, be looked at as like, what? Like, you're better than us, or you're too snobby, or you don't want to learn about who we are. So if you want to communicate, right, you got to get to know someone's, you know, culinary history, their language, yeah, their religion. And she says in her experience, even though at this point she's not considering, if she chose to, she would have full support of our family, because to her, if you choose someone, you choose the whole person.
Right. Yeah, I agree. Tara Lee writes on Facebook, nope, I wouldn't convert any part of me unless I deemed it to be for the betterment of my life. You fell in love with me a certain way, and chances are I will remain that way. And I agree, I wouldn't convert. I wouldn't. My Christian faith is a big part of who I am. And the other part of this is, be it private or public discussion, I always find that it's the woman that's converting. Right? Why? Honestly, it's like it's the women that are converting. It's like, you know what? Why don't you convert for me?
Yeah.
I mean, that's
great point.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh my God. You often see, or at least I've seen lots of friends who get married and they're not religious, but they'll have a religious ceremony. They'll even baptize their kids, and they're not doing it for them as a couple, but they're doing it usually for their parents or their grandparents. And I think even that, like, I don't think I could do that because I feel so dishonest. I'm not religious, so the idea of converting to something that my heart wasn't into feels so dishonest. It feels like I would be cheating my partner and cheating their family.
Yeah,
it's a performance.
Yeah.
You're absolutely right. We do sort of give a pass for some sort of areas. I just admire couples who are able to, and I can't think it would be tricky, where they sort of blend both of their faiths, and they sort of come together and raise their kids in more than one faith, or even some parents expose their kids to a ton of deities, and there are a lot of them, and sort of allow their kid to make that choice on their own. I think those are difficult things to do, but I really have a lot of admiration for parents that can do that.
So, well, I mean, to be very honest, if you look at the world's five major religions, ultimately, many of them share their most fundamental values about humanity. And so there's another point to be discussed, which is, aside from very maybe different practices, when you look at the value system, are they all really that different because they all value humanity in a very similar way? I don't know if it's even that big of a deal.
But I mean, when you talked about like doing things for family members, that was sort of what we had to do, Jacek and I, when we got married. Jacek is Polish, and Poland is super Catholic. I think it's like 80% Catholic in Poland. And I didn't want to get married in a Catholic church, so we ended up getting married in a United church with a female minister, and we took all these pictures, but his grandmother was in Poland, and she didn't make the trip over, so what we made sure to do was ask the photographer to angle photos where you could cheat.